What's up, Wolfman fans? So, like a minute, a little bit ago, I posted a video of me just laying in bed, kind of fighting insomnia, trying to get some sleep. And like I said, I was bored, so I figured I'd go ahead and post a video. It wasn't really a proper video in the sense that it wasn't typically in my style, which is, well, I don't know. I really don't have a style, I guess. But, well, I figured, why not try to get some caffeine? Because in a weird way, caffeine actually helps me sleep, which should probably be an indicator to me that there's a problem. But I want to just go ahead and leave it where it is right there and just kind of just accept it for what it is. And I figured I'd make some coffee for myself. And while my coffee's brewing, I figured I'd go ahead and make another video, a little better video. So, you know, I hope everything's going great in y'all's world. I really hope you guys have an awesome 4th of July. I don't know whether you celebrated it last weekend or you're going to do it the weekend after, or if you're really planning to just like have everything happen on this Wednesday in the event that you are off. If you're one of those quite unlucky, unfortunate people out there who have to work on the 4th of July, you know, my sympathies to you. I've been down that road myself. It is what it is. There's not much you can do about it. You know, life goes on. But I hope you guys still have a great 4th of July, and I hope you guys have a lot of fun. Spend it with some friends, spend it with some family, get a cookout in there, blow off some fireworks, have a good time. And just remember what it's about, though, what we're celebrating, the reasons we're celebrating. These are important things. So that's just something to keep in mind. So a little bit ago, I was talking about the channel I've been watching, Omar Gosh TV. And it occurred to me, I didn't put a link in the description of that video over to his channel. And it's not like me and him are buddies or anything. I just enjoy his videos, and I wanted to share those videos with you guys to see what you guys think of them. I know he'd appreciate, you know, the views and all that, the views and likes and all that stuff. So I figured I'll put a link in the description of this video, so you guys don't have to go typing around, searching. Go, wait a minute, I got half the name in there, but I forgot the rest of it. Go back and watch my video again so you can get the rest of it. I don't want you to have to go through that. I'm just gonna put a link in the description. Make it easy on y'all. But his videos kind of gave me an idea of something that I want to do. And remember I said I was going to probably have to take some vacation time to make it happen? Well, this is very true. One of the things I want to do is I want to go to Gettysburg in Pennsylvania, and I want to see the actual battlefield. And it's more in the effort to show respect and pay my respects to the soldiers that fought and died there. And that's kind of what I want to take the opportunity to go to those battlefields and pay my respects to those soldiers. I mean, it doesn't matter if they're, you know, Confederate or Union soldiers, all of them fought for their rights and their beliefs, and you know, not one, any one person's conviction was stronger than another. You know, you can go into the little nitty-gritty details of who was right, who was wrong. You know, they were fighting for their home, their families, stuff like that. And every one of them fought hard, fought bravely. And, you know, it's just like the Germans in World War II. You couldn't be mad. I mean, I understand. You can't be mad at the Nazis. Those guys pledged an oath of sure, I guess evil is the best way to put it. They swore an oath to it, but like the German army in and of itself, they were Germans and they were fighting for their homeland. Regardless of who their leader was and what he stood for, they were fighting for their home, for their country, and that was their duty. So you couldn't be mad at them. They could have been just the nicest people in the world if you had met under other circumstances. So that's kind of how I have to see it. As a soldier or a former soldier or whatever, you know, I have to have some kind of respect for other service members, other branches, other nations, because all of us have the same thought process in mind and the same core beliefs and values and very similar, you know, reasons for doing the things we're doing. So you're gonna have to, we have a mutual respect. Plus the stuff we share in is stuff that nobody else does. You know, I have a closer connection to somebody, say a soldier in, you know, France or Italy, more than I do with my neighbor down the street. I have more in common with that guy because of the stuff that we have done in our lives overseas and in the military in general. So you gotta show that kind of mutual respect. So going back to where I was at originally, let's backtrack a bit there. I kind of want to go and visit some of those old battlefields. I kind of want to start in Texas though, because there's plenty of battlefields here in Texas from like the Texas Revolution down in, you know, Goliad, San Jacinto, the Alamo, and I've been to the Alamo before. It's pretty cool. There's also some other monuments here in Texas that, and I don't know if monument is quite the right word for it, but that were involved in other conflicts. So you got like the Battleship Texas that was in World War I and World War II, actually pre-World War I. It's one of the last, I think it is actually one like the last remaining dreadnought class or dreadnought style battleship still in existence. And it's still floating. It's still on water. It's not dry docked. And then you get the USS Lexington, which saw action in World War II. And these are just awesome. They're living history, man. It's a floating museum is what it is. And you go down to Galveston, you can also see Seawolf Park, which has got an old submarine, the destroyer, Lone Star Flight Museum, got a lot of old warplanes. But I love seeing these things. I want to go to these places. And again, pay my respects to those who fought, and in many cases paid the ultimate sacrifice so that we can enjoy the freedoms that we do have. And I think it's important on Independence Day for us to remember that. Keep that in mind. Obviously, that's not the focus of it. The focus of the 4th of July is the United States and our independence as a sovereign nation. That's what it's about, and your freedoms. But I think it's something important to remember those who provided for that freedom. You know, anywhere dating back from the Revolutionary War, from the Revolution and the War 1812, all the way up to nowadays, wars in Afghanistan and Iraq, and all the stuff that those guys do for all of us, myself included, as far as them doing stuff for me, because I'm a civilian now, guys. I don't go along and fight anymore. I don't ask for people to thank me. I don't demand military discounts. But honestly, if you're a soldier and you go out there and you demand military discounts, dude, you're garbage. You're a freaking pogue. You don't ever demand that somebody give you something based on you being military. You serve the people of the United States of America. That's part of, I know as far as the Army, that's part of our creed, our soldiers' creed. So this is something to keep in mind. Don't be a dick. Be proud of your service, yeah, but don't be a dick about it, you know? See what I'm saying? Anyways, moving on from that. So I definitely want to do that in the future, and I thought it would be cool to take a couple guys with me, and we'll check this out. Check it out. We'll make a video out of it, also kind of explaining some of the history. You guys are watching that know me, you know, guys, I love history. I'm a history nut. So I want to go down to these places. I want to walk around them and tell you about the history of them, talk to some of the, historians that actually work at the places or they're around the area, and kind of give you a backstory and a little bit of extra knowledge on these things. Not like you can't find a documentary out there somewhere, because I'm sure you can, but I want to show you around it and I want to see it myself. And it's just a great opportunity. So this is something I want to do. I want to start making more road trips and taking more time to do things like this. So I think that'd be a lot of fun. I really don't have anything else much to say. This is just kind of, I want to expound a little bit upon, expand. Either way, I wanted to get in a little more in depth into what my idea was. Again, like I said, I'm not really making any promises because, you know, you guys that follow my channel, my subscribers, you guys know how it is with me. You know, you make a promise to say, I'm going to do this. I swear I'm going to do this. And then life gets in the way. Like I said, YouTube isn't my job. It isn't my life. It's just a hobby that I do when I get the time to do it. So plans a lot of times fall through. But this is something I want to do more than just for YouTube. I want to do it for myself. I want to take my wife with me and you know, make a vacation out of it. Because, you know, it's good to have a vacation. Guys, you got to take time off. You got to take a break. You can't just work 24/7. You know, you end up working yourself into the ground. I know people who do this. And honestly, they're not the happiest people in the world. There's a difference between guys being hardworking and just being a workaholic. There's two different levels. You're doing being a workaholic, unless you just love working and you love putting in that time, and I guess there's nothing wrong with it. You're earning that paycheck and you're being productive. But at the same time, you're neglecting yourself. You're not giving yourself that break, and you're going to run yourself into the ground. You're going to put yourself in an early grave. You know, if you got family, they'd like to spend some more time with you, and they would like to do things with you. So, you know, take that time. Do things with your friends and family. This is important. It's an important part of life. So, I guess that's really all I really want to say. You guys, I really, again, hope that you guys have an awesome 4th of July. And, man, that's about it. As always, like, subscribe. You guys, take it easy. Keep it greasy. That was ridiculous. Let's rewind that. I got that from a friend of mine, by the way, like way back in the day. I don't know why it came into my head all of a sudden now. That was something that we used to say back when I was like in high school. So anyway, you guys, as always, take it easy. We'll see you in the next video. Exit stage left. That's my left, not your left. It'll be your right.